The person that drew number one. Is it Farouk? Well, that will be...
Yes, indeed, the Nation of Domination. We saw them earlier on. And this is an unlucky number to draw number one. So your likelihood of going all the way is not great.
Wait a minute, maybe it's not Farouk. I don't think it is now. Looks like Crush.
When you see one, you're likely to see the other, but I think you're right. Well, certainly they're one less Nation member. Ahmed Johnson put one of them through a table earlier on.
Well, Crush has the longest odds of winning this thing. Only Shawn Michaels has ever started it at number one and won it.
Well, it has been done before. But this man has a real bad attitude. And... All right, wait a minute.
Oh, no.
Crush can't believe it. Yes, it's Ahmed Johnson.
Well, Ahmed Johnson's going to have 90 seconds, a minute and a half, to do just about whatever he wants to Crush one-on-one. And remember the object, to throw your opponent over the top rope, and both the man's feet must hit the floor.
And Ahmed is just the man that can get the job done, as we saw earlier on. And look at this.
Yeah. Oh. He's pleading his case.
And the Nation of Dom, here we go. And Crush going to work on Ahmed Johnson. Crush hammering away now. Actually, trying to pick right up where Farouk left off. Look at this. Crush is all over Ahmed Johnson. Won't let him out of the corner. And again, the object here is not to pin your opponent, not to make him submit.
Get him out.
It's simply to get him out.
We're seeing some Texas-sized aggression from Crush here.
Oh. And Farouk hammering it out with Crush. Sets him up for the ride now. From the other side, he rolls with a clothesline. Ahmed Johnson.
Get him up in the air.
Taking off his feet there. Oh, my. And this has turned into a street brawl.
You got to think that neither of these men even care about eliminating the other at this juncture. Oh, they just want to beat each other up.
Well, I think they want to eliminate each other, but not in the fashion that you would normally eliminate someone in the Royal Rumble.
Crush would like to pick Ahmed Johnson up, throw him over the top rope, and have Ahmed Johnson land right on his head. What?
And Clarence Mason.
Want to have a sidebar, Clarence?
Yeah, he ought to have a salad bar to leave.
What? Clarence is really upset. And again, Crush. Didn't take him long to go right back to the kidneys of Ahmed Johnson. And trying to get the Pearl River powerhouse over the top rope.
But just stand there, Clarence. Help him. Can he do that?
But no, you can't do that. And Ahmed just may go.
Yes. Right down on his head. There you go, Clarence.
Ahmed is so thick. And any second, someone else is going to join the fray, and it's...
The bad guy!
Yes. And I'm told we're having problems with our clock. Oh, my goodness. Like in the NFL, there's an official time and an unofficial time. And look at Razor now. Razor. Greeted with a round of boos. And Ahmed Johnson. Ahmed Johnson eliminates Razor. Ahmed now.
That didn't take long.
Crush. No, it didn't.
Razor's having trouble with his clock. He didn't even have time to rewind it. Ahmed with those new Speedo briefs or something there. What are those tights, McMahon?
He doesn't care about the tights. All he cares about is taking it to Crush and throwing it out.
Look out,
and he's gone. He's gone. Crush is gone.
Feet didn't hit, did he?
You're right. You're right.
That's why the referees are on the outside. No reason for him to be on the inside of the ring.
Both feet. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Ahmed just eliminated himself. There's Farouk. Ahmed going after Farouk. Ahmed eliminated himself, and Crush is in the ring all alone.
He is an idiot.
It's Phineas Godwin there with Hillbilly.
So Phineas first, a Royal Rumble.
And this should be right down Phineas' alley, or trough, so to speak. And Crush right away trying to tie up the big hog farmer. And look at Phineas go. In the Royal Rumble, ladies and gentlemen, you don't need a great deal of scientific wrestling technique in order to win this thing. It's the luck of the draw.
There you go. That's a smart move right there.
And look at Crush wrapping himself around one of those ropes, much like Jake the Snake might do a little bit later on, like a python.
Jake the Snake?
Yes.
He's going to have the python with him?
I suggest he would. And now down on the mat. No one's going to be eliminated in this fashion. Crush.
Ooh.
And Phineas going at it.
I can't believe Ahmed Johnson, his emotion just overcame him. That's just very, very unfortunate for Ahmed.
And again, we can continue, ladies and gentlemen, to have clock problems. But very soon, someone else will be joining the fray.
Yeah, you don't have to wait long. Every 90 seconds.
On Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Uh-oh.
And he's in no hurry, is he?
The bad man right there.
Yes, I'll agree with you.
Well, he's got really no reason to get in any hurry. Let Phineas and Crush beat each other up some more. Maybe it'll make Austin's job a little bit easier.
And look at Phineas. Phineas wisely going to work on Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Not kidding. You better do
Austin
that.
Austin set up for the ride. To the buckle. Here comes Phineas. And oh, what a clothesline.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Phineas is over 300 pounds. That's a pretty tough clothesline.
And now Crush capitalizing.
Come on, give it up there. Don't give it up there.
And Phineas takes a shot to the throat.
Shot to the kidneys also by Crush. On that good-natured yet somewhat simple Razorback.
Somewhat simple. He's being kind.
Well, he's not exactly the brains of the outfit.
He hasn't been in any Mensa meetings lately.
Oh, look out!
Whoa.
And Stone Cold just clobbered Crush. But again, remember, now it's every man for himself. Crush is out. Crush is gone.
Phineas has eliminated Crush.
Oh, just turned around and got the Stone Cold Stunner. It's putting a bad mouth on Phineas. Phineas, oh, no, look at that. Wow, it's about. All around, ladies and gentlemen, Stone Cold Steve Austin, all by himself. And Bart Gunn on his way in. Here we go. Missing Bart Gunn, a southpaw, hammering away on Stone Cold Steve Austin. Gun now setting him up. No reversal coming off the rope and whoa! Drops the leg right across the back of the head and drives the facial area of Stone Cold into the mat. Bart now. Oh, Bart, look at that! And oh, a clothesline!
The first time Bart held on, the second time he couldn't, and once again Stone Cold Steve Austin is picking them off one at a time.
Yes, please.
And he's telling us all he is in great shape. Yeah. He's in fighting shape.
He's in great condition, all right.
I'm sure he's been in a few barroom brawls.
And look at this. Patiently awaiting for the next individual to come out. You talk about a man with a nasty temperament. Ice, well, his watch is working as well as ours. No,
there it is.
How about it?
Austin would love to win this thing to go with his 1996 King of the Ring title. Who's it going to be?
It's Jake the Snake Roberts.
Uh-oh.
That's who it is.
Jake
has Stone Cold. Ah, he's got the snake.
Jake the Snake competing in his sixth Royal Rumble, more than any WWF athlete in history. Much unlike the new generation superstars, this is a grizzled veteran of 42 years of age.
They can keep that snake in the bag. Oh, there's a snake!
And the snake rolling in. And look at the left southpaw. Wait a minute. Coming off the rope now. Oh, what a hard right hand. Jake the Snake Robert with Stone Cold Steve Austin. Rematch from the King of the Ring, I believe, in the finals, where Jake almost won it. And everybody wants the DDT.
Jake the Snake would love to have that one more dance with glory. As we said in the free-for-all, you're two matches away from the WWF title. You win the Rumble, you got one more shot. It's a two-match series to sit on top of the mountain.
Look at this. Come on, Stone Cold. Pick Jake up and slam him right on top of that snake of his. Uh-oh.
And the official has a...
Bring that thing over here.
Off the snake out. And here we go. DDT coming up. Meanwhile, we're 4 seconds away from the next entry into the Royal Rumble with a clothesline. And here we go. The DDT coming up.
Uh-oh.
Wait a minute! Over the top to the outside!
Jake is history!
Oh my goodness! And
look at that!
Here we go! The British Bulldog, who's had so much luck in these Royal Rumbles, now has a personal... Oh yes! Look at this! A personal bone to pick with Stone Cold Steve Austin. Look at him go!
These two men despise each other. They've had a lot of problems in the past. They've been well documented. The Bulldogs had a lot of success in the Royal Rumble. 95, he was a runner-up to Shawn Michaels. He was in the Final Four last year from Fresno.
And I'm not so certain he wasn't the runner-up the previous... Look at, oh, my goodness, look at this now. And driving him down to the canvas.
Bulldog's got a lot of power. He's got experience. And what an opportunity this would be for one half of the WWF Tag Team Champions to earn the right to be in the main event at WrestleMania.
And both, by the way, tag team champions, the British Bulldog and his brother-in-law, Owen Hart, choosing to enter this Royal Rumble matchup. Uh-oh. And look at Austin hanging on.
Oh, there's a lot of things.
Oh, my goodness.
Floating around the locker room regarding the Bulldog and Owen.
And... Is that Pierrot?
That's Pierrot. Pierrot, the champion of champions from the Mexican AAA organization. Pierrot, the veteran.
And if I'm not so certain, he was chosen when a Doc Hendricks top 10. Off the rope now. And go! Bit of a spine buster down on the canvas, and the Bulldog is knocking everybody down.
Pierrot is a notorious rule breaker from the AAA organization. Not very popular here in San Antonio. Has had an illustrious 12-year career south of the border, making his first Royal Rumble appearance and knocking the Bulldog down. And he went for the cover. He saw momentarily, just instinctively, Pierrot going for the cover. And Steve Austin's getting a break here.
Yeah, he was playing it smart. Oh.
And Pierrot just hammered to the canvas. Again, it's every man for himself. Look at the Bulldog. Going to work on Pierrot. So is Stone Cold Steve Austin.
I think Stone Cold and the British Bulldog would like to get rid of Pierrot and then go at each other again.
In the corner, Pierrot. And now Bulldog going to work on Stone Cold. So is Pierrot. Uh-oh, 10 more seconds. Somebody else is going to join the fray. The Sultan.
Whoa.
And there's the Iron Sheik behind the Sultan.
Where's Mr. Backlund? Maybe he's going to enter the Rumble.
Well, he might still be in New York. He was there last night.
Maybe he missed his plane. That'd be a shame.
You find humor in the misfortunes of others, don't you, Roth?
Selectively, yes.
In any event, it's every man for himself, ladies and gentlemen.
Whoa, look out.
No friends in there. If there is an alliance, it's likely to be one that's short-lived. And Pierrot hanging by a thread.
Boy, the Sultan manhandling Pierrot.
He's a big, powerful individual. And look at him trying to... Pierrot.
Those legs wrapped.
That's smart.
All over him.
Smart move by the veteran as Bulldog and Austin are waving away. Austin's in trouble. Austin's.
Yeah. Stone Cold's out. No, he's not.
Remember, both feet have to touch the floor.
And Pierrot trying to pick up the Sultan.
No such luck.
Who's well over that 300-pound mark, I would suggest. Oh-ho!
Ooh, wow, what a slam.
Sultan in his first Royal Rumble.
Look at this. Look how Austin is softening up the Bulldog's legs. Remember, it was that same leg, that same knee that Stone Cold did damage to a little bit earlier on in weeks previous. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Here comes the legendary Mil Máscaras. So now, Pierrot joined by a countryman, Mil Máscaras.
Even though there'll be no allies here, yes, indeed, they are countrymen. That's about as far as that relationship goes. The man of a thousand masks, Mil Máscaras in here.
And here, look at him go to work on the Sultan. Sultan, set up for the ride now. And, oh, yeah!
Wow!
Máscaras in the ring for over three decades. Renowned movie and television star in Mexico. Known as a man of a thousand masks.
And do you know what a feather in somebody's cap it would be if Stone Cold Steve Austin or the Sultan were able to unmask Mil Máscaras right here in the Royal Rumble? Would that be something?
Certainly would be, King.
A headbutt by the Sultan. Meanwhile, over on the far side, the Bulldog with Stone Cold and Pierrot. And they're all tangled up over on the right side of the ring. And Máscaras trying to get the big Sultan up and out.
I need to get a Boy Scout out here to get those guys untied.
Uh-oh, 10 more seconds. Somebody else joins the fray.
Well, Máscaras has almost got the Sultan out.
It's Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Yeah!
Helmsley retaining the Intercontinental title earlier here on the Royal Rumble.
And you can see he's not running at full speed.
Yeah, but now you're gonna see some bodies flying.
He didn't bring his butler with him either.
Or at least not yet. Helmsley, succession of right hands, softening up the British Bulldog.
Pierrot still trying to get Stone Cold Steve Austin up. That's not gonna work in that position, I don't think. And now the Bulldog's in jeopardy of being eliminated.
And Mil Máscaras with Hunter Hearst Helmsley in the mid-ring. We've got Pierrot and Stone Cold on the far side and the Sultan and the Bulldog exchanging blows. And oh, what a left, oh my goodness. What a clothesline that was by the Bulldog. Look out, over he goes, and yes, the Bulldog has just eliminated the Sultan.
A lot of power by the British Bulldog, great upper body strength by Davey Boy Smith, the British Bulldog, eliminating the Sultan.
Boy, Mr. Bob Backlund can't be happy about that.
Backlund has quite a record here in the Royal Rumble.
Oh, yeah, and Hunter has been eliminated.
No.
No, I'm not so sure. Austin now in the corner and drives the elbow down into Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Every man for himself.
There are no allies here. There are no partners, no allegiances,
no lie.
Oh, no, it's Bret Hart. Stinking rotten brother, as Bret would say.
What?
Owen Hart.
I mean, the whiner, he whines about everything.
Listen to you guys, he's a Slammy Award winner.
Right. Oh, my goodness, Máscaras and Pierrot going at it. And here comes the Slammy, and here comes Owen Hart.
Come on, Owen.
Owen and Austin, now going right at it.
Yes, indeed, that'll be most interesting.
I wonder if Owen and the Bulldog will get it on here.
Bulldog is gonna be lucky not to be thrown over after Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Look out, Owen!
Just really did some damage. And, the Bulldog coming right back to Austin.
I bet Stu and Helen Hart are here somewhere in attendance.
And where goes Austin? Austin's going for the ride.
Yes!
Hey, wait a minute.
I think that was Owen eliminated Bulldog.
Owen Hart trying to. The Bulldog is angry.
Bulldog just called Owen an idiot.
They're tag team partners. They're tag team champions.
They're brother-in-laws.
So what? You whiner, it's every man for himself.
I understand that, although Owen was professing that it was an accident. He was
probably was
attempting to get Stone Cold Steve Austin out.
Owen hasn't told the truth since the King was a prince.
Oh, listen to you now. I feel sorry for Owen.
But it is every man for himself, as you brought out, King.
I heard. Football.
And here comes Goldust.
Oh, yeah.
Who gave quite an accounting of himself in a matchup with Helmsley earlier on. And of course, Helmsley is still in there as we speak. Oh, look out. Here comes Austin.
Look at Owen. He's almost eliminated.
Goldust has never competed in the Royal Rumble match since entering the World Wrestling Federation. So this will be a little bit new to him, but it's real simple. It's every man for himself. You start throwing people over the top rope.
Right, here we go. And here's the way Owen dumped. I don't know about that.
It looked accidental.
No,
it did to me.
At least in slow motion, it certainly did not look accidental.
Now Owen's going to eliminate Mil Máscaras.
And look at this. Driving into a moment ago. Stone Cold Steve Austin into Goldust. Goldust in his very first Royal Rumble, as you brought out earlier on, JR. And uh-oh, look out. Máscaras now with
Owen. Hook your leg, Owen. Hook your leg. Under the rope. Hook it up. There you go.
Máscaras is in magnificent condition for a man that's been around as long as he has here in the sport.
Yeah.
To be commended.
I heard he really remembers the Alamo.
Ooh. And Owen Hart, look at that, still in the Royal Rumble matchup.
Sometimes you think Owen's made of elastic. He bends, but he doesn't break.
You wonder what is going on in a Bulldog's mind at this moment. The Bulldog, who has been a stellar performer in previous Royal Rumbles, eliminated by his own brother-in-law and tag team partner. Who's this?
That's Cibernético.
Cibernético.
Cibernético's the youngest competitor in this thing. He's only 20 years of age.
He won't last 20 seconds.
Yeah, well, he can go. I can tell you that. And look at him. He's going right for Máscaras. Cibernético to southpaw, winding up Mil Máscaras. Austin on the far right side of the ring, resting comfortably. Look at this.
Cibernético, my Cibernético grew up a huge fan of Mil Máscaras, as were, I'm sure, a lot of youngsters in Mexico. What an opportunity. I'm sure what an honor for Cibernético and Mil Máscaras to be in the ring together for this young man.
It's no honor to have somebody you looked up to when you were a kid trying to pull your mask off and ramming your head in the turnbuckle.
Meanwhile, Austin over on the far side, as we see, yes, Austin, Goldust, and Owen Hart. And Owen Hart would, I started to say, do that to his own brother. Of course he would do that to his own brother.
You're not kidding.
And wait a minute. We got Helmsley hanging under the ropes. He almost went out. Helmsley right back in. Cibernético, Mil Máscaras, Pierrot, along with Goldust, Hunter Hearst, Helmsley, Austin, and Owen Hart. And in seven more seconds, oh, wait a minute, Helmsley. No, Helmsley.
Still in.
Referees are there to check the feet.
Whoa.
Make sure the feet didn't touch.
Oh, the wall, man.
Here comes trouble.
Yeah, Sable.
Oh, hey, somebody went out.
Cibernético's been eliminated.
Cibernético has been eliminated. Wait a minute, Pierrot. Pierrot dumped outside by Máscaras. And wait a minute, Máscaras going upstairs. Mil Máscaras flying through the air.
Whoa!
Máscaras, I think, just eliminated himself.
He didn't know. Was it?
He may be confused with the rules.
I'm not so sure Máscaras should be allowed to get back in there.
Ole!
Yeah, he got confused there and got carried away. And now the officials are.
Máscaras has made a mental error there. This is his first Royal Rumble.
Whoa! And it is a very unpopular decision by this capacity crowd.
Look out!
Look out! Hunter Hearst Helmsley has been eliminated.
By Goldust!
Oh, yeah! And wild man Mark Merrill. Merrill away.
Look at these two clowns.
Merrill Goldust getting it on. Oh, boy. What an enziguri by Owen Hart. And just think it was just a.
Yeah.
Not that long ago that
they were partners.
That they were partners, Goldust and the wild man.
Well, in any event, it's every man for himself in the 1997 Royal Rumble.
And with Marlene and Sable out there, it may end up being every woman for themselves.
Those two guys shouldn't take it so hard. It was no disgrace to lose to the King.
Oh, please.
What?
Who's it gonna be? Who's coming in now?
That's a Latin lover.
There
That lover making his first Royal Rumble appearance. Started his career as a masked wrestler. Lost his match in the mat.
Oh, right in the keister.
Been unmasked ever since.
And Latin Lover is going to work on Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Latin Lover's a major star in the AAA organization. Is he akin to little Latin Loopy Lou? I don't think so, King.
Oh,
wow. We'll have more music trivia later.
Latin Lover just nailed Owen Hart.
It looks like Sable's got her eye on the Latin Lover.
Oh, please. She certainly doesn't have her eyes on you.
Apparently, Sable and Mero have reconciled, as we talked about last night on Shotgun.
I don't know about that. I hear she's got her eye on Rocky Maivia and possibly me.
A little argument that everyone made too much of. Goldust and Owen Hart has been.
Now look at him.
That athleticism.
He is fantastic.
I think he saw Shawn Michaels do that one afternoon.
Oh, look at that.
That lover going for the drop kick, and Goldust able to step out of the way and step right into it. Goldust! And Owen Hart has eliminated Goldust.
Man! Wow. Who's this guy?
And Red Lover is almost out. And Owen Hart hammering away, and here comes somebody else.
Farouk!
And Farouk wasting no time getting to the ring. Don't tell me it's going to be Farouk in the Nation of Domination winning this thing.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you one thing. Ahmed is lucky he's already gone.
Ooh. And Farouk hammering away on the Latin Lover.
He's not loving that. Whoop.
Nope.
Whoa!
Farouk is our 18th entrant.
Coming off the ropes, Latin Lover.
Look out, Farouk! Oh. Ow! Ow! He tried to catch himself on the apron. He didn't make it. He didn't love that.
Stone Cold and Farouk now. We got a slobber knock over these two.
Stone Cold going at it with Farouk. Wait a minute, Ahmed Johnson.
And he's got he's got Lumber.
Ahmed Johnson wailing away.
Farouk is out of here. He's been eliminated with a 2x4.
And Clarence Mason better get out of Dodge as well.
I guess so. 2x4.
Well, the whole Nation of Domination out here. And Ahmed made certain that Farouk was not going to win this thing if the officials.
Look at him.
Wait a minute. Owen Hart, a Latin Lover out. And that means Stone Cold Steve Austin's in there all by himself again.
Look at this. That's Mero. And Owen Hart have been eliminated thanks to Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Sabio Vega.
He's not going to give Steve Austin any time to rest.
And they have had a go before this history here.
Remember that strap match they had last year on pay-per-view?
A classic.
They whipped each other like animals last year, and neither have forgotten it. The real story in this Royal Rumble thus far is Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Austin now set up for the ride. Here he goes over the top.
Boom!
Into the bucket.
Austin catapulted face first and a spinning heel kick by Savio Vega.
But that's not going to get rid of Austin yet.
Got to get him over the top rope.
Up and out and over. All right, off the rope. From behind now, driving Austin. Austin hooks the rope. Savio Vega back up on his feet and look out.
Ooh.
Oh, no, right on the throat. Stone Cold with a clothesline.
He did it, yes!
Unbelievable. Austin is all by himself. Once again, you might say with all his friends, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
How many men has he eliminated single-handedly?
I don't know.
Look at this, and he's asking for more.
I don't know if those kind of records are kept, but right here you see Austin.
Here goes two right here, look.
He takes out two at one time.
Wow, man, and Owen Hart.
I'd give an assist to Owen there. He almost had Mero out.
Austin, very opportunistic in that particular exchange.
And in 4 seconds, Austin is going to face somebody else. Double J, Jesse James.
Got the promising young singer. I wish he'd promised to stop singing.
And look at this. Look at Austin. Austin playing possum.
Double J's number 20. 10 more men still to come.
And Double J with those left hands. Look at this. Lefts and rights. He is quick.
Uh-oh.
Double J sets up Austin for the ride.
Whoa.
Through the buckle. Double J gets set. Here we go.
Oh.
Double J kicked in the
And the ribs hit over the top. Did he? No, he didn't get it. Triple J. Now, he got him. Stone Cold all by himself again. Stone Cold Steve Austin. And you got to give credit where it's due. You may not like Stone Cold. You may not like his attitude. But Austin is a competitor.
Well, these 60,000-plus fans, I'm assuming, appreciate Austin's intensity. They certainly do not appreciate his attitude.
Who will be next? Who will face Stone Cold Steve Austin in less than 10 seconds?
But the quicker he can eliminate him, the more time he has to rest. Uh-oh.
Yes! 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 He should have won the World Wrestling Federation Championship back in West Palm Beach. He, of course, gave blame to Shawn Michaels for not winning the championship. And the Hitman now with a tremendous opportunity to win the 1997 Royal Rumble. The Hitman, the 21st entry into the Rumble.
Well, Stone Cold has been in this thing well over 20 minutes, just past 20 minutes, I should say.
And he has to be running out of gas, JR. He's been taking rights and lefts from everybody.
22, 24 minutes for Austin.
Oh!
Hard Irish whip from the Hitman, coming with a high impact. Those nasty maneuvers, those tough ones. I'm in your face, Stone Cold, says the Hitman.
And
what's this? Oh, yeah! Hey, McMahon! What's this, baby?
You are in it. I can't believe it. You are in it. You weren't lying.
Get ready.
King Lawler sticking up behind the Hitman, Bret Hart. Look at it. The King is out. And Bret Hart, it looks like... Oh, my.
I think we just saw a record broken. I think Lawler has just broken a record.
I think he just said it. It takes a king and...
to know a king, McMahon. I told you.
You told us what?
It takes a king to know a king.
That's unbelievable. How... do you realize you were just in the ring? Hello, King.
What?
You got your jacket all twisted and wrong set here. You had enough time. You were in there long enough to complete a sentence. The Hitman, Bret Hart, ladies and gentlemen.
24 minutes for Austin thus far. Bret Hart, that headbutt in the lower abdomen. This is so very, very personal. And Bret Hart thought this morning when I talked to him on Superstars that he shouldn't even have to be in this matchup, that he should have come into the Royal Rumble as a WWF champion.
He shouldn't have even been in this matchup.
That's what I just said.
Not because he should be the champion, just because he shouldn't even be in the WWF. It's a jerk.
And who is going?
Uh-oh. Here comes the big man.
6'9", 315, 325 pounds, somewhere in that vicinity. A lot of power and a lot of body weight to get over the top rope.
And here he goes right away on Bret the Hitman Hart.
Yes!
As they say in Oklahoma, Bret got waylaid that time.
And this man can do the job, no doubt about it. Oh, and right back into Austin. No friends in there. Every man for himself.
Well, Diesel's in magnificent condition. Look at that upper body development.
Only seven more individuals to join the fray of the 1997 Royal Rumble match. The winner
of which goes on to WrestleMania to face the World Wrestling Federation champion for the
Diesel,
title.
What are you doing?
And Austin's going out.
Get over there on the Hitman.
And the Hitman, Bret Hart, coming over to help.
Oh, now they both.
Wreck of the eyes by Austin, causing some separation there. Look at Austin and Hart, like two pit bulldogs going right back at it, trying to take a bite out of each other.
And the Hitman to the buckle.
Yes.
With authority.
Bret Hart's sternum just struck the top of a turnbuckle there.
Come on, Diesel, help him. Now's your chance. Help Stone Cold.
Well, here comes Terry Funk.
Uh-oh.
I know he's jumping the gun, so to speak, just a little bit.
Middle-aged and crazy, there's no doubt about that.
Texas legend Terry Funk. And boy, is he ever in a tremendous position to win this thing as well. I mean, drawing number 24. This man.
We saw Austin and Funk get it on last night on Shotgun.
And a southpaw, hard left hand. And again.
Funk was rather outspoken last evening.
To say the least, for which we apologize for. Funk and Austin. Meanwhile, over on the other side, Big Daddy Cool Diesel almost had Bret Hart out.
Almost. Name like Funk. You know he's gonna be that way. He reminds me a lot of Mankind. He doesn't care how much pain he absorbs. He doesn't care what happens to his body. Oh, come on. Terry Funk, get over there and get the Hitman.
Terry Funk's brother, Dory Funk Jr., in the Royal Rumble last year. Of course, the son of the legend, Dory Funk, from Amarillo, Texas. The famous Double Cross Ranch.
And Funk to the buckle. Almost out and over. Upside down. And Funk is going to be out of here. No, not quite.
There he is, getting. Yes!
Hart takes out the midsection.
Oh!
That's gratitude for you in the Royal Rumble match.
Terry Funk with those fists taped.
And you have to wonder whether or not there's a little something extra in there.
Look at this!
Oh, no!
Yes!
Hart! Power driven.
He didn't get any good, though.
No, he didn't. Bret had a block.
Here comes Rocky Maivia. Here he comes. Here comes the rookie. This man could win this thing.
Stone Cold Steve Austin almost fatigued. He's been in here over 30 minutes now, has Stone Cold.
Yes, and look at Rocky go, taking it to Stone Cold.
And this thing is building right back up.
Rocky Maivia, the son of the great WWF superstar, Rocky Johnson. The grandson of the great WWF superstar, the great Peter Maivia, Chief Maivia, and look at this. All over every. Rocky will take it to you. A great athlete, and out he goes. Austin, it's going to be Rocky who eliminates Austin.
He stayed all this time just to be eliminated by a rookie.
Wait a minute. Funk is thrown over. No. Bret Hart can't quite get him.
Don't go.
And Funk, saved. Funk at hair.
That ring veteran knew where he was, kept his balance to Terry Funk. And now Diesel with a tremendous elbow right to the ear, right to the side of the head of Rocky Maivia.
I still can't believe they're having a Royal Rumble without a king in there. Maybe I should go in there.
King, I hate to tell you this, but you were in there. You've been in there. Do you remember? Look out, Diesel now in the corner, and Rocky strong enough and powerful enough to get the big man out. Hanging on to the ropes, forgetting to wrap himself up there. 5 seconds and counting. Who's going to join us? The 1997 Royal Rumble heating up. Who's going to win this thing? Oh, my goodness.
Well, business just picked up.
Don't tell me this man's going to win.
You got Terry Funk and Mankind in the same ring. The Stone Cold and Bret Hart and these others. Anything's liable to happen.
This could be a dream come true. Get rid of that rookie, Rocky Maivia. And then you got Mankind. You got Terry Funk. You got Big Daddy Cool Diesel. And you got Stone Cold all against the Hitman. Would that be a dream come true?
And look at this thing now. Mankind. In the ring, Diesel doesn't want to have any part of him.
No, Mankind.
Who does? Mankind goes right away to Terry Funk.
Get the Hitman.
And Rocky Maivia. There we go. And he's up. No, Funk hanging on. Hanging on by a thread. Mankind continuing to attack. Meanwhile, Diesel and Rocky getting on in the corner.
Two young lions on one side of the ring. Two great veterans on the other. And then you got two bizarre ones right in the middle there of your screen.
Yes, indeed.
He suplexed the Hitman right there.
Yes.
Way to go, Stone Cold.
Stone Cold content now to just look at him hammer away on Bret Hart's head. Bret Hart's head bouncing off the canvas.
I had to go in there and do that myself.
All right, we've got, ladies and gentlemen, six competitors in the ring. That's what it's come down to. And in just a few seconds, another one will join the fray.
The Hitman with a sleeper. Oh, what a counter by Austin. Causing the separation.
Here comes Flash Talk. And another newcomer, ladies and gentlemen, role of newcomer to the WWF, just like Rocky Maivia, could win all of the marbles here right now in the Royal Rumble.
Where are the funk guests?
And I don't think that they should be involved in this, do you?
I think they're in Terry Funk's dressing room.
There it is. That's a pile driver. That one found its mark. That one hit.
And now Bret Hart must rid the ring of Stone Cold. But he's got to get up to do it. I think Bret Hart is content to just weakening.
Look at Flash Funk. What's he doing?
Funk, all right, from the top. That's a real dangerous throw. Nonetheless, an effective one.
Flash Funk, I might notice no relation to Terry Funk.
Flash Funk is flashy, no doubt about it. You talk about a high risk taker. That's Flash Funk for you. And Austin, hanging on. You're not going to get this man out like that. That's going to be something of high impact. All right, Diesel now with a forearm on Flash Funk. And speaking of Funks, Terry Funk on the far side of the ring is unfortunately receiving all kinds of look at that. Oh my goodness, Mankind. Oh my.
Well, they got three men, three of them left, I understand.
Come on, Mankind, go get Bret Hart.
Three men left to enter.
All right, here we go. Who's coming to town?
Uh-oh.
Oh my goodness.
After a controversial victory over The Undertaker, with the help of perhaps Vader's new manager, we're not sure, Paul Bearer, here comes the Rocky Mountain Monster. And no doubt he'd like to be in the main event at WrestleMania 13 in the Rosemont Horizon in Chicago.
Look how smart he is. He's taking his time coming down that aisle. No need to rush into the fray.
And Mankind has... No. Can you believe he hung on?
Oh, now look, Vader's my man. Who you go after?
Vader's the biggest man in the Royal Rumble at 458 pounds.
Swat that fly.
What do you mean that's not a fly? That's Flash Funk.
Well, swat him anyway.
Oh, look at this. Funk now. Uh-oh, taking succession of right hands and a left in the midsection. And down goes Flash Funk. And look at this. Austin going to work on Vader.
Move, Austin. Let Vader get the funk out of here.
And Austin now. Off the rope.
Oh,
my goodness.
What you get?
Vader's upright at 458 is as imposing as anybody has ever been here in the WWF.
And Austin has been in the squared circle now, being pummeled for over 35 minutes.
Bret Hart's got a score to
settle
with.
It's gotta be a lot of fun. I'm gonna enter this thing next year.
Vader, remember, beat Bret Hart on Raw one-on-one not that long ago. And the match that certainly was not without some controversy.
Here we go, only two individuals left, ladies and gentlemen. Here comes number 29. Who is it?
Oh.
Yeah, here he comes. Here comes the Brains and the Brawn of the Godwin outfit.
Brains!
You talk about a big, strapping individual who can throw somebody out of the ring. That has to be Henry O'Godwin.
It's a great opportunity for Henry. He's around 300 pounds as well.
And look at him right away going for the big man Vader.
Henry was one of the last five men in the Royal Rumble. In 95, the Breaker 2 could have won that thing.
And Bret Hart up on perch to... Oh, that's not the thing to do.
Did you see,
better get down there.
Did you see Henry Godwin knock down Vader?
Yes, I did.
Wow.
And real impressed by Henry Godwin, aren't you?
Well, he's a heck of an athlete, King.
The only guy I know that's got a burglar alarm on his garbage can.
He's lasted a little bit longer than you have thus far.
I'm going to get it now. What are you talking about?
You're in the Bushwhacker category.
In any event, I'm surprised that any number of individuals have not ganged up and thrown Bret Hart out of the squared circle.
I'm in shock over it. He should have had a big bullseye on him when he went in there. Everybody should have went after him.
Something's got to give
one
here.
Man left.
Yeah.
And you can bet something is going to give. Stone Cold Steve Austin moving back in now. Look at this.
And you know who that one man is, don't you?
Well,
me?
Why don't we just save it for everybody?
Yeah,
for the benefit of those of you who haven't been counting.
Ooh. Those of you that have been keeping score, maybe this will let you know who's coming up next.
Oh. And the winner of the 1997 Royal Rumble is on his way.
What happened to the darn one?
That's the way they should have done the whole Royal Rumble.
Uh-oh. Well, one of these men will wrestle the WWF champion, whomever that may be, at WrestleMania 13. And will 13 be the lucky number of The Undertaker?
I can tell you this, it seems to me that The Undertaker had a real rotten attitude after his loss to Vader earlier. And I don't know if anyone wants to get into The Undertaker's way.
Well, Vader's not scared of him, obviously. Look at this. He Vader. Sees The Undertaker coming. Look, here they go.
And there they go.
Uh-oh. There he goes. Oh, right on the button.
The Undertaker wants to get even now with
Mankind.
Vader. But he wants to win this thing more than anything else.
Undertaker and Mankind have had their wars.
Oh,
Undertaker
Austin
and David Austin.
And The Undertaker, what a right hand that was.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. And Austin's going for the ride. Whoa! Did you see the elevation? And Vader's going to go for the ride. Oh!
That's the second time tonight that Vader has felt that one, and under a thunderous ride on Diesel.
Do Bret Hart.
He will, don't worry.
It's every man for himself, and Flash Funk gets some as well.
Hit that hillbilly, too, while you're at it.
And heads collide in the Royal Rumble. The Undertaker. Obviously, now I think we would have to state the favorite here to win the Royal Rumble. And again, you never can tell. Will it be Rocky Maivia? Will it be? Oh, my goodness. Look at Rocky go.
Oh, man. Vader gets through a Flash Funk over Vader's head all the way to the floor. Flash is out of here.
Flash Funk has been eliminated. Terry Funk still in there, along with Vader.
Uh-oh, look at Terry Funk.
Let's take another look at the way Flash was eliminated. Watch this.
No. Whoa!
That's power. That hurts. Scary upper body strength and power by Vader. Which one of these men will meet the WWF champion at WrestleMania 13?
Terry Funk.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen,
Vader.
Chicago, the Rosemont Horizon, as JR stated, the setting for this year's WrestleMania. But who will face the champion? Will it be Bret Hart, who has fought so valiantly and so long to regain his number one spot of contention? Will it be Vader?
Uh-oh, look at
Rocky Maivia.
The Hitman is concentrating on Stone Cold. If it comes down to Hitman and Stone Cold, I'd say it'll be the Hitman. If it comes down to Terry Funk and Vader, Vader.
Stone Cold Steve Austin has been in the ring for over 40 minutes.
Comes down to Undertaker and anybody, Undertaker.
I tell you, I cannot imagine the fatigue, the exhaustion that must be riveting the body of Stone Cold Steve Austin after 40 minutes of hell with these guys.
I'm not even tired.
You must have amnesia.
Rocky may be in he's going to eliminate the Hitman.
The rookie.
No. Austin hammering away, and Vader all over Austin. Vader all over Rocky.
I think Austin must have amnesia. What did he save the Hitman for?
I don't. Maybe he wants to do it himself. Look at Funk and Austin hooked up again here.
It started last night on Shotgun Saturday Night. Look at these two. Look at unbelievable. What action here?
Look at Henry Godwin.
Where?
Henry Godwin held on. Undertaker threw big old Hank over the top, but Hank held on. Came back in, made a U-turn.
And the Undertaker invader. Getting it on. Could it be Vader who has the Undertaker's ticket? Oh, what a right hand by Henry Godwin.
Henry Godwin just knocked down.
Everybody's forgetting about one of the biggest men in the ring right now. Look at him. Big Daddy Cool Diesel.
Good point.
Oh.
Henry Godwin nailing the Undertaker. Like we said before, there are no allies in these things.
No, sir. Henry Godwin can lay him in. No doubt about that. To the midsection. Henry Godwin continuing to pound on the Undertaker. And thus far, we have seen no two individuals hook up as any sort of allies.
Uh-oh.
And look at unbelievable what strength. Unbelievable strength by the Undertaker, who threw Henry Godwin all the way out and just rammed, I believe, his head right into our table. Henry Godwin hurled over the ropes. Take a look at this.
Wow.
And almost, then down
almost
into
right
the
in
table.
Our lap.
And Henry Godwin with a valiant effort in the Royal Rumble. Wait a minute. Someone else almost eliminated. So now.
Look at this.
Look at this.
Uh-oh.
Oh, with a mandible claw. That can do it for Rookie, yes.
Oh.
Mankind eliminates Rookie Rocky Maivia.
A rookie mistake.
Oh.
Ow.
Vader. Vader collapsing. Big Daddy Cool Diesel.
Vader using that bulk again in a man.
Oh. Wait a minute, Mankind. And Funk on the far side. They're just, oh, they're mauling each other.
And that's a shame. I think they're doing it because they like it. I just love to see Mankind and Terry Funk as a team.
And no one has been eliminated. Both feet have to hit the floor.
If those two guys concentrated their efforts, they can eliminate everybody in there.
You know, Mankind and Funk and Bizarre were the great athletes. Great athleticism.
Look at this.
To hold on.
And Funk's been eliminated.
Mankind eliminates Funk. So Funk can gives his chances for the main event at WrestleMania goodbye.
Big Daddy Cool Diesel. Bret the Hitman Hart. Vader, Undertaker, Mankind. Oh, wait a minute, Mankind was just eliminated.
Who got him?
The Undertaker.
Undertaker eliminated Mankind. And Funk doesn't want to leave.
Oh, wait a minute. Funk and Mankind out there with the officials. Now you're supposed to go back to the locker room area, and these two are doing anything but.
Vader hammering away on the Undertaker as this Big Daddy Cool Diesel on Bret Hart.
Waistlock takedown by Austin. Austin all over Diesel.
Come on, Austin.
Undertaker
what are you
and Vader
doing?
In the corner.
And Funk and Mankind.
Austin's been eliminated.
Austin, wait a minute.
He was in there for 34 minutes.
Yeah, the referees didn't see it.
Austin has been eliminated. Wait a minute. The Undertaker and Vader have both just been eliminated.
But
Austin
but
eliminated.
Austin was...
And Diesel's been eliminated as well. And now it's all. No. No.
Wait a minute here.
Here is the winner of the 1994 Royal Rumble, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
He eliminated him. I didn't actually see Austin's feet hit the floor.
Austin eliminated The Undertaker and Vader and Bret Hart, but Austin went out. Bret Hart eliminated Stone Cold, and the referees didn't see it. And Bret Hart is not going to stand for it.
Maybe his feet didn't hit the floor, Ross.
I saw it. I'm sitting right here, King. I didn't even see the monitor.
And imagine Bret Hart.
I was looking at Terry
imagine
Funk.
Imagine what's going on in his mind. Austin was eliminated. We saw it. We called it. The officials were over there with Mankind and Terry Funk and didn't see it.
Bret Hart's
Bret
obsession.
Hart
Bret Hart's obsession with winning our title is so evident. Bret cannot believe it. Bret Hart eliminated Stone Cold, and now the referee saw it.
The Hitman Bret Hart is.
I saw it. I saw it. He threw him out.